Hello. So this is a long occult analysis. I will call it occult, so you think, oh, that's cool, you know. I believe, you know, what should I call it? Something like that. It's from like seeing things a bit deeper behind the curtain of reality, that there is a fractal, you know. There's a fractal, and I have been talking about the not milk. Okay, not milk is the subject that I have been talking about. And if you're a new person here, you are very confused now. What is not milk? That is when you lack prime matter. Prima materia to create the philosopher's stone, you know. So I have the well-formed opinion, let's say like that the philosopher's stone is built from milk. Okay. So this means that it's if I'm right about this. It will be shown in reality, in the fractal of reality, because reality is a fractal. And this commercial here is just one example of many things that I've talked about. It's just a little example, but as you will see, it will fully explain why got milk. Is there and why it's so present and so it has been, you know, when it comes to higher truth wants to approach us, it wants to come close to us and help us know the truth, you know, and to be able to know the truth, we have to. We have to get clues about the truth. What is the truth? Well, we see it all around us and we form an opinion about what's true, you see. And to be able to know what's true, you have to get some kind of indication of what is true. And this indication, you look around you, what is true, what is false, and I tell you that the indication of truth is a bit supernatural. It will come to you in the form of a riddle, puzzle, carefully hidden in reality. And so I happen to be pretty good at seeing this stuff, and it's going so far that my own opinions are aligning with this higher truth, in my opinion, and this means that I'm even better at seeing what's true, and it also means that my opinions become true because I align myself and appropriate myself to the truth. So I when I spontaneously continue, I happen to just say what's true just because previously I aligned myself with it and I learn, you know, I learn from the truth and so I align with it and so now randomly it's true what I'm saying, right? All of this is actually about something more. Got milk, you see. The got milk is a question that you say when you have no milk. You lack the prime matter to create the philosopher's stone. Got milk. It's a desperation, okay? And there is a concept that I don't really like anymore because I don't think we should hate people. Because there is a concept which is derogatory, you know, it is very negative against against something, and that is not nilk, not nilk. It is Clinton backwards, and it's a description of the evil that controls the world, you know. And I don't really like that, so I'm trying to turn that around into the not milk, which is simply more sad. It's a bit sad that someone is lacking milk inside to do the Philosopher's Stone. Well, let me prove it to you. And I can just tell you before I do this video, I am correct, and reality is aligning itself with my opinions, almost as if you see, when you see the truth and you interact with a fractal of reality, there will be a feedback loop in time, and things will simply change to what I, in this case, think is correct. And this is how it becomes, and people just simply will align themselves to that, you know. Okay, let me present it. So let's start. So this is the commercial, the first commercial of Got Milk commercials. We're going to look at that commercial. I will pause many times in the commercial, and then I will do the entire analysis of this. Okay, it's a longer analysis, but we will do now. I will start. Okay.
And that was the Vienna Wood Dance in D, one of my all-time favorites. And now let's make that random call with today's.
So what you see on the wall is Hamilton here, and Alexander Hamilton. This is what I will talk a lot about, okay? When it comes to there will be some history. I will talk about the history.
$10,000 question. It's a tough one. Who shot Alexander Hamilton in that famous duel?
So, who shot Alexander Hamilton? And he has he has Hamilton stuff all over his apartment.
All right, let's go to the phones and see who's out there.
And the duel, you know.
Hello?
Hello, for $10,000, who shot... Excuse me? I'm afraid your time is almost up. I'm sorry, maybe next...
So, there is a lack of prime matter, lack of milk. So this is why the commercial is like this, and it ties together into history like a fractal, like fractal reality, you know. And this is what this video is going to be about.
Got milk.
So let's start with this, okay? So, in actuality, we already have a connection, because not milk is Clinton backwards, you see. And this is something I talked about for a long time in videos. I will show it a bit at the end of the video also, but most of you know about this. So, why are they on the museum facade of... let's see. This shouldn't be here. I'll show this later. Okay, sorry. But So let's start here instead. So Bill Clinton, he inaugurated 1993, and that's the same year as Got Milk first aired. And as I said, Got Milk is kind of when there's not milk, you see. And then Alexander Hamilton, that I mentioned in that was mentioned in the commercial, he had an affair, and it was a spectacular national sex scandal with Alexander Hamilton, just like with Bill Clinton, you know, the same thing. There's a fractal connecting Hamilton and Clinton, and you ask yourself why. Well, Got Milk, you say Got Milk when you lack milk, when, and it's backwards, you see, not milk is Clinton backwards. So Got Milk ties together with this, and so it's all about the connection between Alexander Hamilton and Clinton. It's all about that. There is more. So at the Museum of New York, you have Alexander Hamilton and DeWitt Clinton outside as statues, you see. And you can already now realize that there is a connection back in history to these guys, to these families, to this family. It is so you can see. This is an article about that. We'll read here. I'll read here. New York City was a cradle of two monumentous revolutions, a political and military revolution in 1775, 1783, and a commercial one that followed in the late 18th and early 19th centuries. And two New Yorkers, Alexander Hamilton and DeWitt Clinton, were key players in making those revolutions brilliantly successful. So, and if you read about this, you'll see that there were kind of commercial revolution, you see, especially that, these two guys, Alexander Hamilton and DeWitt Clinton, they worked hand in hand and did very similar stuff. So you can see this, for example. Here's another image of where they fixed this. There's a video where about them together, you see, and the statues, I'm just saying. But you can also see that. There's a book called, the upper right image, In DeWitt Footsteps, Seeing History on the Erie Canal. You can see that the Erie Canal is something that DeWitt Clinton did, you see. It was his main thing to do, his industrial or commercial accomplishment, you see. He was the main guy involved in that. But you can also see that this is what, so the other, with the image of the Erie Canal and this, I'll read bottom left. Construction of a canal from Hudson River to Lake Erie was the passionate cause of Hamilton and his allies. While forces allied to traitor Aaron Burr led the opposition to it. So Aaron Burr was the one that shot Alexander Hamilton, you see. But these two guys obviously worked hand in hand. They did. And DeWitt Clinton came from some kind of richer or a more politically influential family, while Alexander Hamilton was not as much. But then they cooperated and they actually were friends also, as I understand. And DeWitt Clinton is said to be the father of the Erie Canal, according to eriecanal.org, you see. But it was also the main thing that Alexander Hamilton did was involve himself in the Erie Canal work. he was like the main figure when you read about him. It seems like he also was the main figure, just like DeWitt Clinton, but somehow DeWitt Clinton got all the fame from it, you see. But in actuality, Alexander Hamilton did that also, you know. This is politics, so someone will get the main credit, you know. But you can see, neither Alexander Hamilton nor DeWitt Clinton were presidents of US, but you can see that this is an article about Hamilton, but if you search for Clinton, you will find like 18 hits, because they worked very much together, these two guys. And here you can see this also that I read. So they worked in tandem, you know, with what they did. So basically guys, This is the explanation to why Gottmilk involves Alexander Hamilton, because it is a little riddle, and the riddle is that Alexander Hamilton was having an affair, just like. And it was like a big deal. It was a national scandal with his sex affair, just like Bill Clinton, you know. It was the same thing. The commercial was first aired the same year as Clinton became president. And then Alexander Hamilton was he had his career next to DeWitt Clinton, and you know they are tightly tied together, both Alexander Hamilton and DeWitt Clinton didn't like Aaron Burr, which was the opponent to the Erie Canal construction, so there's a clear connection here between things, and there is a clear reason why the commercial that lacks milk, there is a not milk, the not milk commercial is bringing this up so that everything is tied together in a neat way, you know. I like to say that everything is a big orchestra, and things people play together in this orchestra. I like to say that it's poetry. Some people like to say that it's scripted. Scripted. I don't like scripted. I don't like to say that it's scripted anymore, because that implicates that there is someone in charge. Someone is not in charge here. We are playing together in an orchestra and we define truth together. And in this case, it seems like my opinion about this has imprinted itself into reality. Maybe because it's a good opinion, you know. I'm trying to avoid the gaslighting of this family. Actually, I'm trying to do that, and instead saying that there is something about it. There is more like a sadness of the lack of prime matter, the lack of spiritual, like, excellence, you know, when it comes to the material and all of this, the materialists and things like that. So let's continue. So what did we talk about so far? Well, we have the Monica Lewinsky having not milk on her lips from meeting Clinton, you know, Clinton leaving his not milk on her, you know. And we have the retrocausal t-shirts of the not milk on her, you know. Then we have, because not milk is financed by Jeff Bezos, you know. And you have all of this stuff. Notmilk.com, and you can see when you use the Wayback Machine that Notmilk.com has milk being given by God to Adam, you see. And this is a sign of, I mean, this is a guy that made this website, Notmilk.com. He doesn't know really anything, you know, about this, but still some people know tiny bits of the truth, and they will just say it like that, like he did here, in the form of an image. He will show that, and I mean this image, he will show that he shows that, I mean, even though he's against milk, he shows that God gives milk, you see. And that's very very telling, you know. He couldn't stop himself from showing this, even though he's against all his stuff is against milk, you see. All his website is against milk, almost as if, because he sees that he's missing something. He knows about that intuitively, and this is why he has this image on notmilk.com. If you look with the Wayback Machine, look to year 2022, somewhere there, and you will see that notmilk.com has milk being given by God to Adam. And so there is a sadness, again, the sadness of lacking milk and the sadness of lacking the spiritual excellence. And this is also what this commercial Got Milk is trying to express. And again, no one really knows what they're doing. They're just doing this spontaneously, automatically, automagically, you know, automagic. It happens by itself. So in a sense, maybe this commercial was a reminder of the lack of prime matter, and that's it, you know. And as a little end to this, I'll make a little funny note here that Hamilton Fish, he lived at the same time as these guys, Alexander Hamilton and these, I mean, about the same time. And Hamilton Fish is a direct descendant of Peter Stuyvesant, and he's named after Alexander Hamilton because his parents were close friends to Alexander Hamilton. So the direct descendant of Peter Stuyvesant is somehow named after Alexander Hamilton. It's really interesting to me. You can check this yourself if you look through Wikipedia, you'll see it. I just thought it was very interesting. I'd like to end with that, you know. It's pretty clear how it is, you know, with not milk and got milk and do you got milk? No, if you don't, you know, got milk, get milk, you know. It's the secret riddle that is going through the reality. And I hope you enjoyed the video. See you another time. Bye bye.